anniversary for release, and the game that we are talking about today is, you can't see the title, but it is Planet Zoo. Zoo is like the new age, like Zoo Tycoon type of game. I absolutely adore this game. The creators of this game took a lot of time into studying specific things and all the information that they needed, so that way it was as animal-centric, animal-informed as possible. So, we are going to be making a zoo to get today, but just any zoo. I was thinking very specifically a large cat reserve. I've always wanted to do a large cat reserve in this game ever since I saw the first season of Tiger King on Netflix. I watched it initially as a joke with my friends, but I just was fascinated by the whole debacle there. That since then I wanted to do like my own big cat reserve safely in a game, and Planet Zoo is perfect for that. So why don't we have that a try together? So let's go ahead. We're going to be starting a sandbox, because it says build your dream zoo with no restrictions, so we won't have to worry about any like financial restrictions or just like benchmark restrictions, like unlocking certain animals or things like that. So let's go ahead. As you can see, I have quite a lot, and I had started like a cat reserve here. I called it Mary's Cat Reserve because that's the name of my cat. Her name is Mary Ann. I've mentioned her before. So I had done that. I didn't really get very far at all. I did not mean to do that. So why don't we load that up really quick? I mean, if I load it up and it's like empty, then like sure, we'll do that. Especially because I hope most of you are here for the whispers and trying to fall asleep and things like that. I really struggle with the whispers, I think. There's actually more done here than I thought. We have a whole exhibit already. Impressive. Zookeeper area back here for like the staff and everything, with the entrance to the exhibit. How many especially for reserves, like, you wanna, okay, yeah, we have a breeding pair here. So the company behind this game, Frontier Games, really wanted to make sure that the animals, like, pre-generated names were close to, like, origin, like, the countries they're from names. So we have our male jaguar here, whose name is Itzley. Let's go ahead and, oh, look at him. I love cats. I love cats of all sizes. She's deep diving. Look at her. Oh, she's beautiful. You guys see her? We can see that she's swimming underwater right now. Cats are very good swimmers. Look at her go. Isn't that just so cool? So cool. You can see her beans. I spy. By bean sprouts. That's my favorite term for the hair that grows between cat's paws. Look at her go. She's just having a good time. You know what, ma'am? Let's go ahead and let her continue doing her thing. So her name is Seltzen. Seltzen. Yeah. That's her. So as you can see, it's getting kind of dark. I can move it. There we go. Yeah. There we go. Let me just kind of keep. It's not super dark. Alright. So why don't we go ahead and build our next reserve. Why don't we, you know what? For sake of jaguars. Let's go ahead. We have to make sure that the zookeepers can reach it. So we have to build the path. That didn't go very well. It's not letting me get a very good curve. Okay, what if we come from over here? See the pop-up of the jaguars are about to mate. So in this game, they don't go as far as showing you. As you can see, they just kind of nuzzle each other, which is very cute. Oh, they're expecting offspring. How exciting. They're due January year two. It's currently September year one. That's a very fast gestation. we're so fortunate. Like, it's usually so, like, quiet and, like, peaceful. It's usually, like, it's usually so quiet and peaceful and nice, you know? And then my neighbors do something. That's just unrealistic, you know? But still. Resistance grade of 5, which is great. It's not climbable and it's watertight, so those are all good things. All good things we're gonna set. Let me see, I want to do one-way glass. Snap, because it just makes things easier. I know it's not as pretty. It's like, is there a way to just make it straight? No. Straight. It's like, pick your point, and then from there it'll be straight. Anyway, like I was saying, I understand that, you know, a square, just a square habitat isn't exactly, like, visual. Select the whole thing. Well, see baby. See baby. See baby appear. Oh no, baby, come back. He's like, I'm gone. Goodbye. Alright, she just had one cub. Oh, it's a little girl. Let's take a look at her. Oh, look at this little baby. Look at this little baby jaguar. Oh, look at her. She's so cute. Look at her little face. Look at her big beets. Such big beets. Oh my goodness. How adorable. Oh, okay. Alright. We saw C-Baby. It's time to return. Just scroll through. Actually, let's look at the list of species. So, I'll read all the species, and the ones that are large cats, I will check off. So that way, we can just look at the cats that we have to choose from. So, we have an aardvark. most giant tortoise. Gemsbok. Kareel. Giant anteater. Giant panda. Greater flamingo. Excuse me. Grizzly bear, Himalayan brown bear, hippopotamus, the Indian elephant, the Indian peafowl, and the Indian rhinoceros, the jaguar. Zebra, a polar bear, the proboscis monkey, the pronghorn antelope, the pygmy hippo, the red kangaroo, and the red panda, and the red ruffed lemur, the reindeer. Gazelle, timber wolf, West African lion, Western chimpanzee, and lastly we have the Western lowland gorilla. I'm going to scan a little bit, make sure I didn't just go on autopilot and miss any of our large cats. Snow leopards and some West African lions. So I'm going to avoid doing the snow leopards because they require a whole, like, you have to do temperature control. We do a cheetah. Let's do a cheetah. So we're going to adopt this male named Obi, as in Obi-Wan Kenobi. We'll adopt him. And then we'll adopt this female named Parika. zoo. So that way we can have them delivered. So while we are waiting for that, let's go ahead and start getting our habitat ready. So the first thing that I like to do is terrain work. So I like to wait until the animals are here. So that way hopefully we can get the terrain laid out how they like. Because certain animals, you know, prefer different things. I think they're coming right now. So as soon as they're in the exhibit, we will freeze. And then we can pull up their personal panel to find out what they like. So here come our babies, and they're plumping out. Alright. Let's go ahead. Staff. Work zones. Edit work zone. Add leopards. As you can see right here, this is navigatable land area. So they're very happy with the size of their exhibit. So we're doing one thing right. And then down here, it tells us what they're looking for. So the two that are in the red are grass short and grass long. Grass short is too far under in the red. And grass long is too far over in the red. So looks like we're just gonna mess with this, you know, change a lot of it. We'll do a little bit of soil, like just over here. We'll dot some so that way we can get a nice texture, can't we? But that's really more for me than for them. And then we need to give the babies some water. So we can do just a little, we'll do like a little O shape. Well, that's not an O. That's a rock at the bottom, because that's where the water is going to be. Alright, we're going to calm water to there. So they got some water. It's actually quite a lot. As usual. Shelter. That's what's red right there. So after that, I like to go to environment. they don't want a lot of coverage. They're cheetahs, you know. Continents, Africa, biomes, desert, and grassland. So what you can do, you can go in the nature tab, and you can filter those things. So Africa, and then our biomes are grassland, desert, and automatically we have things that we can put in our habitat that won't absolutely piss off our cheetahs. Last thing anyone wants is a mad cheetah, you know? I don't want to piss off the cheetahs. The zookeepers don't want to piss off the cheetahs. So yeah, they don't really want too much going on. So we'll keep a lot of the plants over by the water because, you know, roots need water. It's not super pretty, but it's what they want, you know. Put some rocks. So, I'll put a question, if you're still awake, I'll put a question out there for anyone who's watching. What is your favorite animal? Either like exotic animal or not, or just a domesticated animal. Like what's your favorite? What's your favorite one? Or favorite ones? I know sometimes only picking one can be heartbreaking. Domesticated animals. I'm sorry, I lost track of my own question there. With domesticated animals, I love cats, obviously. I also love horses and dogs, you know. I mean, it's pretty hard to not at least appreciate dogs, you know. I've had list for every animal I meet. But I think of all animals, I love cats the most. I feel the happiest with cats. I feel the most at home with them. So, while I was rambling on about animals, I was getting partially distracted by doing the finishing touches on this adorable little habitat for our cheetah breeding pair. So they have this nice log shelter with a lot of bedding. They have a scratching tree enrichment. They have a hanging feeder enrichment. They have a sprinkler right here, a prey scent sack, another food enrichment item. I made sure they have plenty of enrichment going on. That's their food tray and their water trough, and then they have plenty of fresh water that is being filtered with the little water treatment that we put in. But yeah, so that is our cheetah enclosure. So that's gonna be it for this video. Please let me know what you thought of having Planet Zoo as our our content, our background content, whatever. I don't know. Are you here for the rambles? Are you here to actually watch me play the game? I don't really know. But whatever you're here for, let me know what you think of Planet Zoo. If you'd like to see more, if you would like me to just read some stuff from the Zoopedia. Let me see. The Zoopedia is like the breakdown of all the species, all of the information, their social needs, fun facts. Like I could read stuff about the animals in the game, things that they're okay with eating, like their diets, what their lives would look like out in the wild typically. You know, they also go into like endangered species revival efforts that the zoos, like zoos around the world, are putting effort into. You know, like, just let me know. Let me know if you'd be interested in seeing more. I am currently trying to get a photo of our cheetah here. Shot, but I might have forgotten. Let's see, is it? No. Let's see. Oh boy. I never really know for sure. This always be happening. sun. Oh, that's not bad. Alright. We'll just have to settle for that, won't we? Alright. Well, with that, I hope that you have a wonderful night. A wonderful, wonderful night. And remember, remember, remember to keep it friendly. Thank you, everyone.